Now, this may look like just another Android phone. You may think that I'm just browsing the internet here, but I've actually got a Wi-Fi adapter connected to this phone. And as you can see here, it's running Kali Linux. So as an example, I can swipe up here. I'll put in the default password, which is 1234. And as you can see here, various apps are available. I'm interested in the terminal. Now, this phone is running Linux natively, in this case, Kali Linux. Can run other flavors of Linux as well. But what I can do here is run Wi-Fi tools such as Wi-Fite using this Wi-Fi adapter to attack a Wi-Fi network. Now, only ever attack networks that you own or have permission to attack. This is my own Wi-Fi router, and I've given myself permission to attack it. So I'm going to run Wi-Fite now, put in my sudo password, 1234, press enter, and now Wi-Fite is running. Now, the text is all over the place because I've zoomed in so that you can see what's happening. But basically, we've got two Wi-Fi cards. I can either use WLAN 0 or WLAN 1. I'm going to use WLAN 1, which is this Wi-Fi adapter. So I'll enter 2 and press enter. And what that's doing now is enabling monitor mode on this Wi-Fi adapter so that I can attack a Wi-Fi network. Various Wi-Fi networks are shown here. Again, text is kind of jumbled up. But I'll press Control C here to stop that. And scrolling up, the network that we want to attack is this TP-Link network. That's the one right here. Number is 1. So I'm going to select 1 and press Enter to attack that network. First attack that it's trying is Pixie Dust. Then it's doing a null pin attack. It'll go through various attacks, but you can skip them by pressing Control C and then C to continue. So as an example here, it's doing a pin attack. Control C, C to continue. Now it's trying to do a PMKID attack. Press Control C there, press continue. And now what it's trying to do is deauth clients from the network and capture the four-way handshake. So on this phone, I'll enable Wi-Fi and then I'll connect to that network. And notice as soon as I did that, it captured the four-way handshake. And what it's trying to do now is crack it. And there you go. Password is kind of off the screen there, but it says Spider-Man. So it was as simple as that to crack a Wi-Fi password on this phone because the password was configured really badly. The Beekeeper movie highlights a very unfortunate situation in today's world. Scammers are going to scam people and they have no mercy. They will scam anyone. Could be your mother, could be your grandmother, could be someone else in your family. They could even try and scam you. This is unfortunately the world that we live in today. Hackers are going to hack. Scammers are going to scam. Your data is out there. You may have been very careful with your data, but companies are being breached all the time and data is being sold by data brokers. And what amazes me is how that's even legal. How can companies illegally sell your data? Here's just a simple example. Hackers got nearly 8 million people's data from 23andMe. The firm then blamed users in a very dumb move. This is from the Guardian website. Another example from the BBC. People's DNA is who knows where now. Now, you may be very careful with your data, but unfortunately, a lot of companies are getting breached. The Have I Been Pwned website shows that 14 billion accounts have been pwned. Just one example from Facebook, 509 million records were compromised. Your data is unfortunately out there unless you do something about it. I interviewed Sam Curry, who showed how he could hack a Kia car with just the number plate. A lot of people in the comments of my video said, that's ridiculous. How can they hack a car with just the number plate? Well, he explained how the DMV is selling your data. So he was able to take the license plate of a car and get the VIN number of that car because the DMV has a system where you can get that kind of information. That's being sold online. Your personal data is unfortunately out there. You can go and manually remove that data if you want, or you can use a service like DeleteMe, who I am using because of the recommendations of people that I respect in the industry, like Rachel Toback. She's done some fantastic demonstrations with CNN where she has cloned someone's voice, spoofed their telephone number, and been able to do things and get passport details and other information by pretending to be someone that she's not. Now, don't think this will never happen to you. In 2024 alone, in the US, the FTC received over 1 million reports of identity theft. Personal example that I have is I know someone who told me the other day that scammers were able to take out a loan in his name because they found his name, birth date, and other information online. and they were able to apply for loans. Be careful with your information. So it's really important that you get your personal data removed from the internet. Now, if you want to join Delete Me and get your personal data removed from the internet, use my link, joindeleteme.com/Bumble, and get to 20% off. Now, in this example, I'm running Carly NetHunter Pro on the phone. If you go to carly.org and click download, you can download a mobile image, so NetHunter. So again, I'm using NetHunter Pro here. NetHunter Pro is available on various devices, including the PinePhone. This is a PinePhone Pro, but it's also supported on other phones. So what I'll do now is download the NetHunter Pro software for the PinePhone Pro so that I can show you how to get it installed on the PinePhone. Now, the PinePhone is great because it runs Linux. This is only one version of Linux. But one of the things I like about the phone, and I mean, there are many things to like, I'll just power the phone off, is that it has a removable battery and you can use a micro SD card to boot off different operating systems. So what I'll do is take the lid off the phone. So simple as that. And as you can see there, big battery, PinePhone 64. And I can simply remove the battery. Notice here, this is the SD card that's running Kali Linux. Now you could remove this if you wanted to hide what you're doing. So as an example, let's say you're traveling. You could simply have the phone boot into its default operating system. And even if you have the SD card in, so what I'll do is put this back. It's not going to boot into Kali unless you specifically tell it to do that. So as an example, if I simply turn the phone on, what it's doing now is booting off the internal flash. So as you can see, it's not booting into Kali Linux. As you can see here, it's simply booted into Manjaro Linux. Even though I have Kali Linux installed and available on the SD card, it's not booting into that by default. So if someone took your phone as an example, all they would see is Manjaro Linux, and a lot of people probably wouldn't know how to use it, but they wouldn't be able to see Kali. If you wanted to boot into Kali, you would have to turn the phone off. So I'm going to turn it off now, and you have to press the volume down and power button at the same time to get it to boot into Kali. So what I'm going to do now is press the volume down button and power the phone on. I'm going to hold the volume down button. Notice that's red at the moment, but should hopefully turn blue. And there you go. So that's turned blue now. And what it's going to do is boot into Kali. And there you go. We're now booting into Kali Linux. This is once again a PinePhone. It's available here, pine64.org. I'm not being paid or sponsored to talk about this phone. I purchased this phone myself. It's great to see that we have a Linux option for a mobile device, even though I don't think this is good enough for daily use as a traditional phone, but you may be able to get it to work in your case. A lot of people would probably prefer Android or iOS, but fantastic phone to run Linux natively on the phone, as well as boot natively into Kali Linux. Please note, this is not running Android at all. This phone is running Linux natively. And in this case, it's running Kali NetHunter Pro natively on the phone. I'll now show you how to install Kali Linux on a PinePhone. In my example, it's a Pine 64 Pro. So first thing, go to Kali.org, click download, go to mobile, select the image for your phone. So in my example, it's PinePhone Pro. So I can click download to download that. Next piece of software you need is Etcher. So just search for Etcher in Google, or you can go to this URL and click download Etcher. I'm going to download it for Windows. They do have options for Mac as well as Linux. But in this example, I'm using a Windows computer because that's what most people would be using. So as you can see, I've got Etcher downloading and I've got Kali downloading. I've already actually downloaded Kali NetHunter Pro, so I'll cancel that download. Now, before you boot into Kali, like I've demonstrated, you need to install the ToeBoot bootloader on your device. So I'm going to click on that link, and that takes us to this page. We need to use ToeBoot for either the PinePhone or PinePhone Pro. In my example, it's the PinePhone Pro, so I'll click on that link, and we are given the command here. But that's not what we're going to be using in my example because I'm using Etcher. So I'm going to go to the ToeBoot repository and I'm going to go to ToeBoot at the top here and go to the latest release, which is 2023-07-007 at the time of this recording. So I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to download the software for my specific phone. So the phone that I'm using here is the Pine 64 Pine Phone Pro. So I'll download that. So again, you need Towboot, you need Etcher, and you need Kali NetHunter Pro. So I'll open that up, and here you can see the files that have been downloaded. Now, this is a tar.xz file. I'm going to right-click and go to Show More Options, and I'm going to use 7-zip to extract the file. Now, if you don't have 7-zip, simply do a Google search as an example for 7-zip and then download it. It's free software. So I've extracted that software here. It's a tar file, so I'm going to extract that again. So Show More Options, 7-zip, extract the file. And there it is. The file that we want to use is SPI installer image file. So what I'm going to do is run Etcher. I'm going to select that file, which again is my downloads directory. It's this 2023-07 tar file, and it's this image file. So I'm going to click open. The target is going to be my SD card, which I've inserted into my computer. So again, you just need a micro SD card. So I'll put that back into my computer. So here's my SD card. I'll select that and then I'll flash it. So we have to use Towboot to update the bootloader on the phone. Then we have to create an SD card that has Kali on it. So that's now completed. So the next thing I need to do is power the phone off. So I'll power it down. Okay, so the phone has powered down. I'll open it up, and what I can do now is take the battery out. What I'll do is replace this SD card, which is currently running Kali, with the SD card from my computer. So what I can do now is put the battery back in. You need to hold the RE button down when you boot the device up. So I'll hold the RE button down and then power on the device. So hopefully now it'll give me the option to boot into Towboot. It's gone yellow there. Okay, and there you go. So I had to hold the RE button down and then release it. And now, as you can see, we can install Towboot to SPI Flash. So I'll press enter there and I'll start the installation. As you can see, the software is now installing. Okay, so installation has successfully completed. We can go back to the menu and we can power off the device. Okay, so what I can do now is boot it directly into Kali because I've updated the firmware on the phone. So what I'll do is take another SD card and put that into my laptop. This is the Kali software. So what I'll do is Show More Options, 7-zip, extract that. So I've extracted the Kali software that I've downloaded. So you can see this image directory has been created, and inside there is the actual image file. So I'll go back to running Etcher. File we're going to flash once again is in my downloads directory. It's this 20.0.24.3 PinePhone image. And there's the image file. I'm going to select my target, which is my SD card, and select that and then flash it. So as you can see, it's now flashing. So it's now verifying. And there you go, flash has completed. So I can close this. And what I can do now is remove my SD card. So on the phone, once again, I can remove the battery, take this SD card out. I could have written it directly over this card, but that's got my Towboot on. So what I've done is write Kali to a separate SD card. Again, you don't need to use different SD cards. You could have just overwritten the one. Put the battery back and then put the cover back on the phone. Okay, so now when I turn it on, I need to hold the volume down button. So keep holding the volume down button. That's red. That should go blue. And there you go. And hopefully now it boots into Kali Linux. And there you go. We've now booted into Kali. I can put in my password or PIN in this case, 1234. And there you go. Apps are now displayed. Press console. And I now have a console. You could type all the commands manually here, like installing Wi-Fi, or you could SSH into the phone, which is great. I mean, this is Linux, so you could just SSH into the phone and use your computer to configure the phone. So on my phone, I can go to settings. I could connect to Wi-Fi, but for this example, what I'll do is forget that connection. And what I'll simply do is plug the phone in via a network adapter, and hopefully in my console, I'll be able to ping google.com. And as you can see there, it succeeds. So I'll press Control C to stop that. IP address on the phone is 192.168.0.150. So hopefully what I can do in my Windows computer is ping that IP address. So 192.168.0.150. And as you can see there, pings are succeeding. So what I'm going to use, because this is a Windows computer, is PuTTY and SSH to the phone. I have to accept the public key, log in with a username Carly, PIN number 1234. And as you can see there, I have successfully SSH'd from my laptop to the phone. So as an example, if I type the command sudo wifi, so that command is not found. So sudo apt install wifi. You don't have to use wifi. It just makes wifi testing much, much easier. So we have to install a certain amount of software. So I'm going to say yes. And as you can see there, the phone is busy downloading the software. You could obviously type all these commands directly on the phone. It's just easier in some ways to use the computer and SSH into the phone. Another advantage is if you've got two network adapters, you could SSH into the phone and not be right next to the phone. So I'm going to just say yes to allow non-super users to capture packets in Wireshark. And as you can see, various software is now being installed. Okay, so there you go. Wi-Fi has been installed, so I can use the command sudo wi-fi to run Wi-Fi. And there you go, it's now starting. But notice a bunch of software is missing. So we're told that we should install HCX, Dump Tool, Mac Changer, and other software here. So sudo apt install HCX Dump Tool. And you're literally going to use sudo apt install for the other software that it wants you to install. Or you can go and install it directly from GitHub, as they're showing you here. But I'm going to use this command sudo apt install HCX tools. So copy and paste that. Go to do sudo. So sudo apt install HCX tools. And that's now done. We go to install Mac Changer. So sudo apt install Mac Changer. Say yes. So let's type sudo wifi again to see what it tells us is still missing. So as you can see, I'll cancel that. We've got to install, according to this bully, and hashcats. So sudo apt install bully. Say yes. Now again, I am using SSH into the phone. So all the software is being installed on the phone. The last piece of software is hashcat. So we could install that. It's not actually necessary because we're not going to really use hashcat on the phone. It makes more sense to use hashcat on a GPU or something else. But as an example, we could install hashcat using that command. Okay, so there you go. Software is now installed. If I run sudo wifi, it's not going to work now because I don't have a network adapter that supports monitor mode. So enabling monitor mode on WLAN 0 failed. So what I'll do is exit my SSH session and I'll unplug this and I'll plug in my Wi-Fi adapter. I'll open up the console directly on the phone and now type sudo wifi and press enter. Password is going to be 1234. Press enter. So now what it's done is pick up that there are two adapters, WLAN 0 and WLAN 1. So what I'll do is select 2 and press enter. And now what it's doing is enabling monitor mode on this Wi-Fi adapter and picking up various Wi-Fi networks. And again, I could attack my little TP-Link network over here. And now what it's doing is running Pixie Dust attack and then the various other attacks. So I won't bore you going through that whole attack again. You're basically going to decide which attack to use. In this case, I'm going to wait for the handshake. And on this phone, I could connect to that network and that's now been captured and the password is cracked. Password at the top here is Spider-Man. So there you go. I've now shown you how to use Carly NetHunter Pro on a phone to attack a Wi-Fi network. I've also shown you how to update the bootloader, so ToeBoot. I've shown you how to install Carly NetHunter Pro on the phone and then boot it into a new version of Carly NetHunter Pro. Again, this phone is fantastic in that it allows you to run different versions of Linux. You can boot into the default version of Linux installed on the flash, or you could boot into another version of Linux on the SD card, as I've demonstrated. Now this video is getting long, so I'm going to end it here. Hopefully you enjoyed this video and have learned how to install Carly NetHunter Pro on a Pinephone. fantastic phone once again. Let me know in the comments if you enjoyed this video and the kinds of things that you want to see me create. I'm David Bomble, and I want to wish you all the very best.